Future submarines, US Navy's Columbia class versus Royal Navy's Dreadnought class. Two next-generation submarines are scheduled to enter service with the US Navy and the Royal Navy during the 2030s. We take a look at how they are being developed, including potential capabilities and unique features. Within the past decade or so, the US and the UK have been developing separate future submarines for their respective naval fleets. Both the Columbia and the Dreadnought classes are expected to enter service by the 2030s. What unique capabilities might the different classes of future submarines have and what progress has been made in their development? US Navy's Columbia class submarines. The Columbia class was announced in 2014 to replace the US Navy's Ohio class ballistic submarines. The new Columbia class under the Ohio replacement program. According to the Ohio Replacement Project document, it will be similar in size to the Ohio class but will be heavier at a displacement of 21,144 tons compared to the Ohio's displacement of 19,041 tons. One of the key features of the Columbia class is its electric drive propulsion system. The interesting design changes made to the Columbia class is the switch to an X-shaped configuration of rudder, from the existing cross-shaped design now seen on Ohio class and Virginia class. This allows the controls to be smaller, reducing the resultant drag. X-stern configuration reduces the chance of an accidental dive, allowing for faster speeds at lower depths. 12 Columbia class subs are planned for construction with the first beginning in 2021. General Dynamics Electric Boat won the contract to build the new submarines in 2016, and will receive help and expertise from Huntington Ingalls Industries Newport News Shipbuilding. In May 2019, Huntington announced it had cut the first steel plate for the maiden vessel. The Columbia class will be armed with 16 Trident 2D5 ballistic missiles. The US Navy said that the two classes will share a common missile compartment design for interoperability, and UK Royal Navy will also be adopting the X-shaped propulsion system on their new Dreadnought class. Royal Navy's Dreadnought class submarines, named after the former battleship. The development of the Royal Navy's Dreadnought class of future submarines kicked off in 2011, when the UK government signed the initial assessment phase for procuring materials for the first vessel. On 18 July 2016, the House of Commons voted to renew the UK nuclear deterrent programme Trident, and subsequently committed to the Dreadnought programme, which at the time was known as the Successor class. The UK plans to build four Dreadnought-class submarines at a total lifetime cost of £31 billion, according to the MOD, although it has set aside a contingency sum of £10 billion. The new Dreadnought class, built by BAE Systems, is expected to replace the existing Vanguard class within the Royal Navy. It will be larger than the previous class, with a length of around 153.6 meters and a total displacement of 17,200 tons. It will use the Rolls-Royce Power 3 nuclear reactor, a US design that is said to be simpler and safer than the Power 2 nuclear reactor on the Vanguard class, while also having a long lifespan and lower maintenance requirements. The Dreadnought class's armament includes four 21 inches torpedo tubes to fire BAE's Spearfish heavyweight torpedoes, and 12 ballistic missile tubes that act as the nuclear deterrent and fire up to 12 Trident 2D5 submarine-launched ballistic missiles, each carrying 8 warheads. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe.